I have this microphone on now. Boop. Hair's looking good. Let's begin. Hey, what's up, Facebook? It's Christina Milian. I am so happy to have you guys here today because today is my first episode of What Happens at Home. There's so much more. Oh, ding dong. Let's do it again. What's up? Okay, hold on. You okay, Violet? There's homework happening in the background. Mom life. Okay, I'm so excited to have you guys here. So many of you know me as an actress. You also know me as a singer. But what you might not know is I own my own small businesses. I have a jewelry company called House of Fine Gold. I also have a food truck where I serve beignets. It all started at home. My best friend, we were roommates. We started making beignets in the kitchen. We were starting to get all these requests from people like, hey, can you make some for my birthday? Can you bring some to my party? And next thing you know, we were like, these beignets are so good. We need to do a truck. We need to get out to the people. Let's just bring this party on wheels. The beignets that we make are as good as the ones in New Orleans, if not maybe even better. You know, our fans definitely say so. So I will pat myself on the back. Me and Liz, my best friend. Well, I think we did pretty darn good. Then I had the jewelry line. I was into beading and I was making beaded bracelets, necklaces, and I had a lot of my friends asking me about it. Next thing you know, I had a jewelry line. Whether it's food, it's fashion, a movie, anything like that, I want to know how it gets made. I will Google it, I will get a dictionary, I will thesaurus it, I'll find out how it gets done, and if anything, I like to test it out at home. Why not just try things? Nobody's watching. Actually, usually nobody's watching, but this time you guys are watching. Whether I succeed or I don't do the best at it, that's what life is all about. Since I've been home, we've tried out a whole bunch of different things, including how to make pizza dough. It's not as easy as you think. We have tried and tried. I'm telling myself that this time, you and I, we're gonna get this done. Pizza is constantly on my mind. When I was pregnant with my son, I had this dream. All these different pizzas just popped up in my dream. I think my whole second and third trimester, all I could think of was pizza. Anywhere I'd go, I'd say, make sure you get pizza as an appetizer, pizza just anytime. Pizza's been on my mind for quite a few months. Now I have to say, LA's pizza scene is, it could be questionable. Ooh. I don't think I've had great pizza in LA. Nothing that I've gone home and talked about like for days. Maybe this is my calling. You know, this literally happened on the spot. Just like the beignets and bringing beignets to LA, I might have to make the best pizza dough and start a pizza truck. This is how I get in trouble. This is how I start up all these ideas. But you gotta start somewhere. Like I said, I have messed up this dough quite a few times. I have not gotten it right. And every time it happens, I get sad, I get mad. I have to literally walk away, take a breather, and then I remember to myself, I'm like, okay, you didn't go to school for this. There's still real pizza dough makers that are still not getting it right. Please remind yourself, if you can't get this right, we can always try this again. I don't even know that I'm actually gonna get this right. We could all just walk away. Woosah. I feel better. Positive thinking. Let's put it out there. So the first dough that we messed up, the dough ended up being too sticky. It was just, I think there was just too much hydration in it, too much water. Maybe the water wasn't warm enough. It was so sticky, it was sticking to our hands. No matter how much flour we put in afterwards, it just didn't work. So I think the best thing to do is to add water as you go and don't pour all the water in at once. Now the second time we tried, we almost got it right. And for sure, I think we didn't put enough yeast in it. So it wasn't able to rise. If you can get the measurements right, even though I thought I got the measurements right, I'm giving you this advice like I know, but I think this is what it's all equated up to, okay? So this is the equation. The third time that we tried it, I did another one that was just an easy pizza dough, which it was just like add hot water to this flour. It was great. I got everything right with the, it looked right actually, the dough looked right, but when we finally got to making the pizza, it was stuck to the pan. It was stuck to the actual counter. I couldn't get it off of the pan and into the actual wood burner to cook. So I decided to really take this on to the next level. So the last time I used all-purpose flour, but today I have 00 TPO flour. So if you actually go online, do your research, it says that 00 flour is the best. And now you don't have to use any particular brand, but there's some great ones by Caputo. I want mine to be really authentic and kind of European, so 00 flour is the way to go. You're gonna need some yeast. I've got my salt, We're gonna use also some warm water. Don't forget, that's a big deal. Warm water, please, use warm water. If you don't use warm water, you'll regret it. And then of course the measuring cups. So let me get my measuring cups out. Boom, boom, boom. And a bowl. Aha, got it. Okay, so my man, he's French. I have his measuring cup, but I don't understand anything that's on it. Can you see this? It's all in French. I'm gonna use his, unless I can find mine. Oh, here we go. I had it in my hand. Ding dong. Anytime you actually need something, it's sitting right in front of you and you just don't see it. I found it. Oh, and then the other thing I found out from my sister, because my sister's a chef, there's a difference between measuring liquid and, you know what? She's the chef. Basically, if it's like mass, like powder or anything like that, if it says a cup, there's a different kind of measurement compared to actual liquid, whatever. So the recipe that I'm gonna use today, my man, his best friend, makes pizza at a restaurant that I love in France. It's in Paris. It's called Zzzz. Babe, what's Greg's restaurant called? Juicé, Juicé. Juicé. They have the best, truffle pizza. I got a recipe from him. I'm trying to make their dough. Babe, I need the recipe. You texted it to me? So I'm getting the recipe for my man who's hiding. He refuses to embarrass himself over this pizza dough because he's French. So I've got a recipe, it's by Gino Sorbillo. It's a Neapolitan pizza. And just like you're watching me right now, I'm watching him. Darn it. Here it is. This is actually by Caputo, which is great. They're using the pizza flour. Babe, it's not even in English. Thank you. Getting some help here. So 1.5 grams of yeast, 45 grams. See, then what is that?
Kilograms.
Oh, but it says grams.
Kilograms.
Okay, so farina is flour.
Farina is flour.
750 kilograms of flour.
No. 750 kilograms is the weight of a car. 750 grams.
Yeah. You can already see how this is going already. You and your crazy hair are as crazy as this pizza.
It's this one.
Farina.
It's like
300, and then 150.
Yes.
So 300, 300, and then 150.
750 grams.
750 grams. Let's try it. 750 GRS, whatever that means.
Grams.
Alright. Alright. Boom. Pour it on in. Ooh. Pour that baby in. 750 grams of 00 flour. The good stuff. Now we're gonna add 22 grams of salt. I'm gonna have to Google what grams. Let's Google it. Come on, give me a converter.
Yeah, not even the half of this.
Okay, so this says 50 grams right here. So we're gonna take our salt. Like many things, we're gonna make a guess. This is 50, I'm guessing 22 is around here. Pour that in there. That's 22.
What?
That's what?
That's more than 22.
There we go. For the yeast, the amount is.
Right. Slow down, baby. Yeast is usually 1.5 grams of fresh yeast, but you divide by 2 because we do the half of this recipe, so it would be 750 milligrams. And then you divide by 3 because the dry yeast. Divided by 3.
750 divided by 3. It's 250. Oh, I could have told you that. I have a tablespoon. Tablespoon and teaspoon. I know this could be a little confusing, but I promise I will give you the actual directions in the description. Make sure you look there. Now you can see why we haven't gotten this right yet. In English, it would really help.
So 0.3 teaspoons.
0.3 of a teaspoon?
Yeah, it's less than quarter.
Of a teaspoon.
It's just a little bit.
Like this? I say this, can you see? Oh wait, I'll do like they do in those like, oh. I'll do like they do in those, oh.
That's where it's supposed to go, in the water.
Okay, it goes in the water. But how much water?
Did you pour the...
No, I don't have the measurements of the water. Oh my God. So I'm guessing that that's 0.3. Okay, now we're gonna fill up warm water and you're gonna put your yeast into the warm water. That's where it's gonna go first. Now I've got my trusty assistant to help me. He's gonna eat this pizza later anyway, so if it's even done right.
Pizza will be ready in 2 weeks.
Pour that in there and we're gonna mix it up. Now we got everything. I put the salt inside the flour. Yes, a little bit of water. So what we're gonna do now is we're gonna mix this up. Only gonna pour a little bit at a time. That's the mistake I feel like I've been making. I'm gonna do this with my hand. Let's get messy. Here it is. So we've got the flour, salt all in here. Now, my assistant's hand is gonna pour in some water for me. Okay, go for it. Okay, I'm mixing. I'm mixing. All right. All right, we're starting to get like a nice little dough going. Okay, both hands. Ooh, babe, look, it's working. Both hands in there and start mixing the water, the warm water, by the way, make sure your water is warm, and yeast together. It should almost be like Play-Doh. Ooh, it's heavy. Whew, this is like a workout. Look at this stuff right here. Ay, ay, ay. This is a really good workout. You see, it's really thick. Get all the flour up from the sides. Mix it in there, it's gonna get messy. This is like the adult version of how to make slime. Make pizza dough. Ooh, look at that. I think we've almost got it, babe. We have this much more water left. I don't think it's wise for me to add any more water right now at this moment. By adding a little bit at a time, you give yourself space to add more if you want to. But at this point, you're gonna mix it so much and you're gonna knead it and beat it. It's supposed to beat it. So you like take it. Oh, I need some flour on it. Put some flour on your counter. Take your dough and you're basically gonna keep doing this, but then now you're gonna bring it on down to the counter and you're gonna start beating it, okay? Literally, beat it. Ah, this is fun. You're having a long...
Guys, that's the first time.
We did it!
Oh my God.
We did it!
Oh my God.
I made pizza dough, guys! You guys, I got chills right now. I'm so happy. I think we do. It's a little bit bumpy and lumpy. Put it into a little perfect circle like this. Take a nice pretty bowl and let your dough. We have pizza dough. It's like I should name him. I'm gonna let this sit for the next 6 hours. I'm gonna put a wet cloth on top of it so the dough can rise and we can make the perfect pizza or the most imperfect perfect pizza.